Leader of opposition Mathias Mpuuga has revealed that opposition political parties plan to engage the NRM party to review the electoral laws with the aim of ending the electoral violence that was witnessed in the last general elections. He disclosed this while opposition in parliament was meeting with a delegation of European Union ambassadors at parliament, where they deliberated on a number of issues pertaining governance and democracy. Here's more.
Mathias Mpuuga says that there is need for all political actors in the country to deliberate on how the Electoral Commission can be empowered to independently handle the electoral process. In this, opposition plans to sit on the table with NRM party to dialogue for the good of the country.
Bring the country to deliberate and have a candid conversation about these constitutional and electoral gaps, including engaging the ruling party to empower the Electoral Commission so that does not remain a paper tiger and will fail to regulate and take care of their responsibilities.
In a closed-door meeting, which lasted 2 hours, we learned that European Union engaged the National Unity Platform to rethink their decision of snubbing IPOD.
They were only asking whether we have reconsidered our position on IPOD, and we have informed them that as NUP, we have not reconsidered that position, because that position is the party position and cannot be changed by the opposition in parliament. The opposition in parliament obtains its legitimacy from the party position on every matter. We do not have our own issues different from what the party thinks. The party gives us legitimacy and we implement the position of the party. The party position remains that we are not part of IPOD.
Mpuuga also expressed a need for a country to find ways to control the increasing debt burden and find other alternatives to fund the budget. He castigated President Museveni's interference with public procurement by hand-picking contractors, and this shields them from private sector competition.
Taunting a private sector-led economy, and there's no way you're going to do that when you are in contract centrally. That compromises the entire arrangement of entrenching the private sector. The private sector is highly dependent on what government spends on. And if you're going to compromise that by centralizing particular undertakings of government, then you have a problem.
The European Union ambassador to Uganda, who led the delegation of ambassadors, pledged to partner with the opposition on a number of issues.
If you could look at us as partners, if you look at what is going on in the world, the European Union has relationships with every country. Most of these relations are good. Some of, with some countries we have a little bit of frictions, that it is normal, it's part of the of life. But we don't do development partnership with most of them. In fact, we work on across all kinds of issues.
It was a great opportunity for the delegation of European Union ambassadors. First of all, to come and interact with us as legislators, especially from the opposition. This gives them chance to hear the views of Ugandans, the local ordinary Ugandans, because ordinarily they have been interacting majorly with the state actors, which in most cases do not house the views of Ugandans. We want to see their more emphatic engagements and comments, and probably recommendation on democracy and the rule of law.
We have shared a lot of issues pertaining to our services as members of parliament. First and foremost, we have highlighted the need to safeguard our natural resources. The land tenure on which these natural resources are fixed, especially forest cover, is being threatened